It's been declared a global emergency. In Australia, it's of national significance. And while it's not a sexually transmitted infection, right now monkeypox is spreading through the gay community. But are we doing enough to stop it?
A huge amount of kind of anxiety washes over you. I just got back, I'd seen some of my friends. What if I've accidentally given it to them?
Jack Barlow is one of about 120 Australians who have contracted monkeypox.
Do you know how you got it? Where were you?
I know there's stories out there where people have gotten them at large parties or festivals. I actually caught it off just a single holiday fling in Provincetown in Massachusetts. Just something any normal 26-year-old will do overseas, and it was actually on the same day some of my symptoms began.
Since May, outbreaks in the Western world have caused widespread alarm.
Hey guys, this is what monkeypox looks like.
I couldn't sit. I couldn't walk standing up straight. As you'd imagine, going to the bathroom is a huge ordeal.
Spread from person to person through direct skin contact or through bodily fluids, monkeypox, or MPV, is a viral infection closely related to the virus that causes smallpox. Once infected, you may experience a raft of flu-like symptoms, fever, headaches, body aches, and chills. But it also causes a rash, which shows up as pimple-like lesions. They tend to appear on the face before spreading to other parts of the body, hands, feet, and the groin. And they can be extremely painful.
And I wish this on nobody. Wouldn't wish this on anybody.
Luckily for Jack, his symptoms were considerably milder. He spent the next 3 weeks in isolation, but chose to make light of his predicament.
All right, well, good morning, everybody. To 8 p.m. last night, New South Wales Health has notified us of one additional case of the monkeypox virus.
So I came out on TikTok dressed as Gladys doing a morning presser.
I would like to further announce that positive case was me.
I could have felt miserable about myself, or I could have done something, and that's how I think about it.
Just needed an excuse to dress up as Gladys.
I never need an excuse to dress up as Gladys.
More than 52,000 cases of monkeypox have been reported across 93 countries so far this year. The WHO says 99% of cases outside of Africa are in men. And of those, 98% are men who have sex with men. And with that comes an all too familiar stigma that this is a gay disease.
The monkeypox, the big gay disease floating around. It's only the gays getting it. Have you seen the dirty scabs that everyone gets?
It's a dog whistle that feeds into this nasty mentality that a very, very small minority of people have, and there's just no need for it.
If I was a doctor, I'd put a sign up, no monkeypox patients admitted.
Oh, you can't do that as a doctor.
You can't, no.
I think you can do whatever you want as a doctor. You don't have to have every Tom, Dick and bloody dirty monkeypox victim coming in there, do you?
What he said had no basis in scientific fact.
Bill Botell was a key architect of Australia's initial response to HIV and AIDS.
It was a form of hate speech, I think, and there should be some retraction, and we should not go down this terrible path of demonising, stigmatising and vilifying people.
So this is a great opportunity for us to be like, look, this is what it is, this is what it does, this is where you're most likely to kind of get it. And let's, you know, start the work now to limit those modes of transmission.
The good news, there is a vaccine, but supplies in Australia are scarce.
We are now one of only a very limited number of countries that have been able to secure supplies.
The federal government has bought 450,000 doses, but at last count, only 22,000 are available. So at-risk groups have been prioritised, including gay and bisexual men.
And that's why the most at-risk communities have got to moderate and change behaviour until the vaccines can catch up with the demand.
A method that's working overseas, with case numbers dropping 21% in a single week after a month-long upward trend of rising infections. But with tens of thousands of people from around the globe set to attend World Pride in Sydney next year, it's a time to be cautious.
We are in a better position in relation to monkeypox than we were with these other diseases. and it is a race, and we don't want it to spread.
I still think I'm the only person in Australia to come out publicly about it, and it hasn't done wonders for my love life. But hopefully nobody else gets it, but hopefully we can break the stigma and people will be able to talk about it.
The worst thing we can do is stigmatise this. I remember in the mid-'80s, you know, with the AIDS virus around and the scare campaigns and people putting misinformation out there. I mean, the mortality rate of this, fortunately at the moment, is just 1%, but it's a really awful, awful disease to get.
Good thing Carl Sanderlands is not a doctor, isn't it?
This is true. I mean, I think the reality is that when you don't have big public information campaigns like we had during the pandemic, that's an environment in which misinformation can thrive and can start to dominate the conversation. I think what we can all see, you know, you pointed out to me earlier, you didn't realise that this was actually circulating in the Australian community. It is. It is here. It is circulating amongst the gay community, but it is not a gay disease. But if you do have worries about it, just educate yourself. All of the information is available online. The vaccine is coming, but you do need to take precautions for the time being.